everyone, welcome back to my channel, or hi if you're new here. Today's video is going to be my March favourites video. So I've been doing one of these each month since the start of the year and I absolutely love it. I love to look back on them as well and see what my favourites have been and to also share them with you guys. So if you want to see what my favourites were for March, then keep on watching. So I've got a couple of bits I want to go through as always. Usually the topics are like food, beauty and hair, and I tend to throw in like a couple of entertainment things. So I've got more beauty this month than anything else, so I'll probably start with that, to be honest, just to throw that out there. So I want to show you my favourite nail polish of the month, because I've done that the last few months because I've been painting my nails each week, apart from this week because I'm trying to get them into some sort of good condition, but they just don't really want to grow. So yeah, there's not a lot I can really do with my nails at the moment. I haven't painted them, but I will be sorting them out soon. So anyway, my favourite nail polish of March has to be this little Nails Ink one. This is such a pretty colour. It's like a, it's quite grey, but it's kind of like got a hint of blue as well. And this is in the shade Palace Gardens. When I painted my nails with this colour, I had fake tan on, so the video I'm gonna pop up on screen, my hands do look a bit orange as it was literally the next day. So just ignore that, but you can see the colour. It's a really gorgeous colour. It's a really good quality polish as well. I actually got this in my March glossy box, I wanna say, so I'd put it on like as soon as I got that. So yeah, this is hands down my favourite of the month. I absolutely love it. Now carrying on with like beauty stuff, I had to jump on the trend of the new Maybelline mascara because literally everyone was going wild for it, like on TikTok, and it just, you know, blew up. So while I was in Superdrug a few weeks ago, I thought I would pick up a few bits, and I picked up this mascara and it did not disappoint. So this is the Maybelline Lash Sensation Sky High Mascara. This is supposed to make your lashes like super, super long, and I've been using it most days. I don't actually have it on today. I mean, it would have been good to try it on to show you, but I didn't think about that, so I don't have it on today. But it does such a great job, and it's really good at just extending the length because it's this really nice fine comb that can get right from the root of your lash. And yeah, absolutely love it. Really affordable as well, so that's why I wanted to throw this in here. So, you know, we've got some affordable things going on. I think it's under £10, maybe like £8 or £9, I want to say. Definitely worth the hype. Next product, I think I gave a little sneak peek on that. I said it was going to be in my monthly favourites, and that's the Misguided Beauty Range Freckle Pen. So they've recently bought out a beauty range, probably about, I want to say maybe within the last 2 months, and I picked up the freckle pen and I also picked up the brow marker pen, and this one had to make it into my favourites. It's so easy to use, and I like to have freckles especially this time of year because it kind of just adds to the look, just makes it look cute. So I picked up this one and I love it. It's just in one shade, and it saves faffing around with an eyebrow pencil or trying to do them in any other way. It looks quite natural, and yeah, just a quick easy one to throw in there. Again, quite affordable if you're into freckles. So another makeup product is by Makeup Revolution, and this is actually a lip liner. So when I went into Superdrug, oh, just dropped that on the floor. This happens every time, I swear. When I went into Superdrug to pick up the Maybelline mascara and a few other bits, they actually had 3 for 2 across like their whole range. So I grabbed that one, I grabbed the new e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer, and I picked up this, which is just a Revolution lip liner. I've never used any of their liners before, so I wasn't sure how it was going to be. This is their Satin Kiss lip liner, and I think it's in the shade Chauffeur. I didn't want to pronounce it last time I mentioned it in case I got it wrong, but I think that's what it is. And it's this gorgeous nude shade. I actually have it on today. and then I just popped on some of my Urban Decay lipstick, and oh my god, it's such a nice colour, and I would literally go as far as saying this is a dupe for the Charlotte Tilbury lip liners. The quality of it, so good, and it's really really creamy, so it's super easy to put on, it just glides straight on. I have other lip liners that are like super dry and they just don't go on as nicely, but this one I definitely give massive thumbs up, because as I said, drugstore, much cheaper, and just does such a great job. Moving on to a bit of skincare, another March purchase was actually this product by The Ordinary. Now this went around online months ago, can't even remember how long ago, but it was a long time ago, because it's basically like a peeling solution. So you pop it on your skin and it's bright red, and then you leave it for 10 minutes and then you wash it off, and it's supposed to kind of exfoliate. It's like a mask, and you take it off, and I've used this only a couple of times, so I'm yet to see kind of like true results and have a really valid opinion, but my opinions on it so far, my skin feels so much softer after I've used it, and just cleaner and clearer, so I've loved using that. The only thing with it is you've got to be careful with it and only use it like once or twice max a week, because it is quite strong. The first time I used it, I put it on and it was a bit of a shock, because it does kind of, you know, things tingle. This tingled to the extreme, this stung quite a bit, I'm not gonna lie. It didn't give me a reaction though, because I took it off like the first time I kind of was using it, I did take it off like straight away because I thought this doesn't feel right, but that's just how the product's supposed to feel. So yeah, full opinions will come on this one soon, but so far so good. Now just moving into like the more foodie stuff. This month I decided to make a Maltesers cheesecake as I was really feeling it. I think if either in last month or the month before, I mentioned that I made some Biscoff cookies and they were so good. Every time I bake something that's nice, I feel like I'll just put it in one of my favourites, because it's genuinely been like my favourite treat of the month. So we made this huge Maltesers cheesecake, and we've been slowly making our way through that this week, and we've still got a little bit left to be honest, but I'll put a picture up on screen if I even took a photo of it.
Just want to say I did take a photo of it, but I didn't actually save it.
But yeah, super easy to make. I'll leave the recipe I use linked down below if you're interested. Another food thing is these protein bagels. Now I know this is super random, but these are delicious because they're bagel thins, so they're much better for you, and they're seeded, which just gives it such like nice taste, and they've got 8 grams of protein in, so you know, a great source of protein, quite healthy for you, a lovely snack. Sorry, I just got interrupted by Ryan, he just creeped in to get a jumper. Where was I? A lovely snack, and yeah, quite healthy, delicious, definitely recommend. They are a bit more on the pricey scale because I think you only get 4 in there, and I want to say they were like £2.50, which is quite a lot really when you think about it, but 10/10 from me. But what's going on with my hair? It's awful. Okay, next one is oat milk. Again, random, but I tend to drink a lot of iced coffees and stuff like that, and I don't like to drink a lot of dairy because my stomach is quite sensitive to dairy, so I found a milk substitute, a dairy substitute for milk like last year, and I've been drinking soya, and it's okay, but that's all I kind of ever drank. And then the other week I thought, oh well, I'll decide to try some oat milk because I've heard that it's really good, and it is so nice. It's super super creamy, which is so good in a nice coffee or with your cereal. It just makes it taste so much nicer, so I definitely would recommend oat milk if you've not tried it, especially as an alternative if you want to come off dairy milk. I've tried almond milk before, but again, it kind of made my stomach a bit weird, so oat milk's definitely the best one I've tried out there, but it'll be different for everyone, I can imagine. And now just some kind of entertainment bits. some things we've been watching this month. We've actually watched quite a few things this month. We've watched quite a few movies, but most of them honestly were pretty crap. And obviously this is my favourites video, so I'm not going to be talking about them in this video to recommend because I didn't enjoy them. But we use Netflix most of the time and they're always coming out with new stuff. So yeah, we like to keep on top of whatever we can that we enjoy on there. And one of the series we watched throughout this month was Behind Her Eyes, and I absolutely loved it. I just thought it was done so well. There's been a mixed review on that, I think. People have loved it and other people have hated it, but I really liked it. Ryan enjoyed it as well, and the ending was so good. There was just a huge twist that we weren't expecting. So if you haven't seen it, I would recommend. I won't give any spoilers as to what happens at the end, but it's a massive plot twist. So yeah, the next good one we want to kind of rave about is a movie we watched called Greta. This I think was recently added to Netflix, and it's got Chloe Moretz. I never know how you pronounce her name. Chloe Moretz, I want to say is. I like her, she's a really good actress. And this film came out a few years ago and I actually wanted to go and see it in the cinema at the time. I remember it being advertised, but I never went for whatever reason. And yeah, it came on Netflix. We decided to watch it the other night and it was really good. It's kind of, that's my sort of vibe. I like kind of, I don't know how you'd even explain it. Like, it's not, well, it kind of is a thriller. Like, I don't know, it's just a weird psychological film. So yeah, I won't give anything away if you haven't watched it, but I would recommend if you're kind of into that sort of stuff. And then lastly, for things I've watched, last night I actually watched this, and it was the new Roman Kemp documentary. Find what it's actually called. It's on BBC, so I didn't watch it on Netflix. So it's called Roman Kemp, Our Silent Emergency. And it's just really eye-opening and like educational if you know anyone or has known anyone that's committed suicide. It's just a huge eye-opener for a lot of younger people, I would say, to watch. Like, I really do recommend it if you've not seen it, because he lost a friend and he touches on that throughout the documentary, and that's basically what it's about. And he goes around the UK to other families that have possibly lost someone and just kind of digs into why so many men, especially in the UK, commit suicide every year. It's such a tragedy and something needs to be done about it. So for him to do this documentary and raise more awareness is such a great thing, and I enjoyed watching it. As I said, I would definitely recommend if you haven't. I was trying to think if there was anything else I could add into my favourites, because I always do the same kind of categories, which is fine. And I think when kind of lockdown's eased and we're allowed to go out and do stuff, I'll have way more things to talk about in these videos. Like, oh, this month I went here and it was great, but obviously we haven't been able to do that, so there's not a lot I can really add. I will say, yesterday we booked a trip to Centre Parks because we were supposed to go last year that got cancelled, so we've booked that for September. So fingers crossed that goes ahead and we can go. That's something I was super excited about in March. And yeah, I think as we're now coming into, it's Easter weekend this weekend, and things are easing off a bit more, so hopefully I'll have more plans and more things to share about. But for now, I think that is my products and everything I want to talk about done, to be honest. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's all of my March favourites, so I really hope you enjoy. If you did, please smash a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here, as that would mean so much to me, especially if you're an ongoing viewer and you watch a lot of my videos but haven't yet subscribed. If you could, I would so appreciate it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!